Asking anyone to forget, we try to get at the truth. After that, people make up their own minds, make their own futures, hopefully for the better. Thank you.
On the right, Unionist MLA's leader, Harry Bryson. On the left, Francis Gilroy, Sinn Féin Minister. Behind him, Johnny Rafferty, Sinn Féin Head of Communications. Coppers, Alec Reid, Chief Constable, Police Service, Northern Ireland. Hello, Henry.
Prime Minister.
Picked a good day. Henry Stanfield, son of a Northern Irish mother and an English father, is in so many ways the best that these islands have to offer. No offence to the Scots and the Welsh. He brings honesty, integrity, and experience to this job. We are very lucky to have him. Ladies and gentlemen, the Truth Commissioner for Northern Ireland, Henry Stanfield.
So how is Libya?
Oh, like everything, it's a process.
Not bad, huh?
I do firmly believe in the process.
Of course.
Sorry to interrupt. The PM's leaving.
Laura Darnell, my legal aide. Minister Francis Gilroy.
Pleasure to meet you.
And you. If you'll excuse us, we ought to show our faces.
We'll talk again, I hope.
Good luck, Mr. Stanfield. Still bringing the truth to unbelievers, Henry.
Why am I not surprised to see you here?
So you've befriended the gunman of the year, 1990?
They tell me he's travelled a long way since then.
The coming man, they say. Who's that? Don't say your legal aid, please.
She's off limits. What are you doing here, Jake? I'm planning another cock-up like the one in Libya.
An advisor of some sort. PM, apparently.
On what? Icing tips.
Very good, Henry. How are you going to survive these people?
Oh, they don't look so bad.
We'll don't get lifting stones, unless you know what's underneath them.
Is that a message?
Yes. Unless you still want to be here in 2020. Narrow the brief. Hello.
Hello.
Laura Darnell, Jake Marston.
Pleasure to meet you.
You too.
The PM?
Yes, of course. Truth Commissioner, with blessings from both the UK and the Irish government.
The truth can and will lead towards healing and a lasting peace.
This
Do you got my number? Bye. All this?
Police files. What they tell us in the files.
Police dragging their feet.
Usual. Those are newspaper reports on the dead or disappeared. Sectarian murder, tribal division, political assassination. All scanned, indexed, cross-referenced, and all accessible from your desktop. Yes? Okay, thanks. Henry? Chief Constable's in your office.
Ah. What are we still missing?
Practically everything pre-1994.
Right. Let's go and meet him.
Good morning, Chief Constable.
Truth, Commissioner.
I'm told that despite repeated requests, you're withholding crucial evidence.
I don't know who told you that.
Personnel files incomplete, special branch files untraceable, smacks of history being rewritten. We do expect you to deliver the files in their entirety.
Any of them are falling to bits. They're 35 years old.
Hardly the Dead Sea Scrolls.
Maybe they had a better class of paper in those days.
I take it you're in favour of the Truth Commission?
Look, we all want the truth.
But?
But what's it going to cost?
Don't obstruct this commission, Chief Constable.
Actually, I just came by to let you know that the missing files have been recovered. They'll be delivered to you here this morning.
Good.
If there's anything else you need, don't hesitate to call me.
Thank you.
the bracelet for day one.
Belfast or Bosnia, the police protect their own. Mark their cards early on, saves time later.
Right, well, you better get reading. We've got 1 week to the hearing start.
Did you have dinner with Jake Marston last night?
Why not ask him?
Did he mention he's MI5?
I guessed he was something along those lines.
He's not a nice man, Laura. Spies never are.
Well, thank you for the warning.
Hello? Is anybody there?
How far is Dunmurry, Beckett?
Half an hour, sir.
Take me there, will you?
Yes, sir. Let's head back.
Marty's bringing the car line.
Right.
You were up again in the middle of the night.
I had that report to read.
You'll end up a physical wreck if you're not careful. Nothing. Kelly's around the new kitchen put in. Car's here. Christine's pregnant.
What?
Just 3 months.
Oh, jeez. Is this why she's marrying this English fella?
No.
Because we'd look after the child.
She's marrying him because she wants to, and his name's Justin.
But you're not at home yourself.
She's afraid you'd have a heart attack. A few days break would do you good.
I'm working on it, I promise.
Yeah, well, I've booked it. Week after next, it's in the diary.
You taking a few days break then, Frankie?
You organising my personal life now?
Of course not, Frankie.
Hello?
Frankie,
is
Christine has been over there?
Pakistan, let me just check.
Your mother told me.
Do you forgive me?
No.
But you'll come and have your morning suit fitted.
I'll see how I feel.
And you'll go easy on Justin.
I'm making no promises.
Be there, or I'll name the child Francis.
Am I the only one who didn't know?
Morning.
Morning.
Yeah. They here for me.
Mother and sister of Connor Roach. Case is set for next month.
What do they want?
To talk to you. I know your daughter, Mr. Stanfield.
Emma.
She's a colleague of mine. We teach at the same school.
I see.
Of course, she's off now on maternity leave.
Yes, of course.
All we want is Connor back, so we can put him to rest.
I understand.
We're not happy with the witnesses you've called.
I'm sorry?
We want the truth. We've written everything down. Times, dates, names, we'd like you to read it.
And if you have time, I'd like you to look at my photograph album of Connor.
Of course.
I'll not take up any more of your time. Some good news, at least.
What?
Going to be a grandfather. Congratulations.
Mind if I join you?
So, you'd like to drink champagne alone?
Can't abide it. Tom, how do you do?
Gusto.
What brings you to Belfast?
Men like you.
Ah. Yes. Where are you from?
Kiev.
Interesting city.
And you? Why Belfast?
I'm a lawyer. I have a client. Are you hungry?
I haven't decided.
You're very beautiful.
Are you married, Tom?
My wife died.
When?
2 years ago.
I know a quiet restaurant near here.
Prefer. Yes, I'd like that.
The Roach file's been tampered with. Pages missing, others substituted after the fact. Reed's swearing with us. Calls me dear.
He's protecting someone.
Obviously. But who?
D.I. James Fenton, Special Branch retired, and Francis Gilroy.
Gilroy? The minister?
Maria Roach claims Fenton ran her brother as an informer and Gilroy had him shot.
Well, that may be more truth than the PM's ready for.
So does Jake Marston, mine. Sounds like it.
Jake completely supports the Truth Commission.
Jake and I have been down this road before.
So, what do you want to do?
We call Gilroy and Fenton before the commission.
Right. You're sure?
Yes, I am. Even if Jake isn't.
Mr. Rafferty.
Your man Stanfield is making waves.
He's not my man. It's an independent commission, what's the pity?
Your Prime Minister appointed him.
You're Mr. Gilroy, does he know?
No, wouldn't that be a good time to tell him? Francis needs a holiday.
I'm afraid that's your problem.
I'm afraid it's yours.
All right, you keep Gilroy on the rails. I'll make sure Stanfield backs off.
To be seen. A spokesman for the victim's family has said that it's unclear
whether it's an extraordinary
process.
And about the so-called
we had to do something.
UVF only took lives.
Well, obviously, I'm sorry,
this
but I regret the loss
of
his wife and family.
But my family had suffered too.
I'm sorry for the hurt done to this man's family, but I'm not sorry for what
I was a soldier fighting in a war. At that time, I felt the victim represented a legitimate target in that war. I deeply regret the pain and suffering caused to his family.
Have you anything else to add?
No.
Thank you. We'll take a 15-minute break.
James, Alec Reed.
Alec?
You're to be called before the Truth Commission. In case of color revolution.
Only me.
I've been told to talk to you. Men in suits. People who don't use their real names.
What are you to tell me?
They don't want Gilroy's name mentioned.
I asked you to keep me out of this.
It's not up to me.
If they maybe go after the truth regardless.
The Federation can help you.
Won't I?
You can't use Gilroy's name.
Is that right?
James, you're the one who recruited this boy. Do you want that to be dragged into the open? Don't make this... Are you taping this?
It's a phone, Alex. Stop it. What the hell's the matter with you? It's a text from Miriam. Look.
Don't make a martyr of yourself, James. Do what has to be done and disappear into your retirement.
Is it due?
Next month.
And how's Richard?
Allam,
sorry. I'd like to meet him.
You probably wouldn't.
Sorry?
Wrong accent, wrong university, wrong shoe.
This is absolute rubbish.
No, I thought Northern Ireland. I've escaped all of that. And then you pitch up, head of the truth police. I should have gone to Patagonia.
I'm pleased you found someone you love, who loves you. And I'd very much like to meet Allam.
Or Richard.
Stop it, please.
Ah, you love the abuse.
I love you, the abuse I could live without.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have been off in the Congo reconciling a bunch of murderers when your wife was at home dying of cancer.
Your mother had thrown me out.
You should have tried harder.
She didn't want me there.
I wanted you there. I was doing it all on my own. How stupid are you? I need your help.
You only need to ask.
Maria Roach, who you met.
I can't discuss the tribunal.
I don't want you to discuss it. I want you to help her.
Did she tell you what was in her letter?
Well, I didn't ask her for specifics. Should I have?
I'll do whatever I can to help her.
You'll listen to what she has to say.
I'll try to give her the truth about her brother. That's my job.
Connor's obviously dead, but not... They need the body home.
Yes.
And they want those responsible to be named.
Naturally.
Do this for Maria. It'll mean a lot to her. And me.
Can I drop you somewhere?
No, thanks. I'll call you.
the time, I believed the victim, Mr. Lorimer, represented a legitimate target in that war. I deeply regret the hurt and pain caused to his family. I am very, very sorry, and beg your forgiveness, Mrs. Lorimer.
Thank you. Mrs. Lorimer, would you like to make your final address?
You destroyed my life, my family. You murdered my mom. You're sorry? I don't want to hear that.
Tell the Chief Constable that we need a larger security presence in the chamber, will you?
Of course.
Christine's wedding, eh? 2 weeks, is it?
What is it, Johnny?
Connor Roach, the Truth Commission.
Am I called?
No. But it could be trouble.
Who for?
All of us. But you're the minister now.
We can find out what that music is, will you? Who has been called?
We found Michael Madden in Boston.
Madden? He was only a kid.
He was there. And all his people are dead. He can accept responsibility and go back to the States as if nothing had happened. Neither you nor I can do that.
Was this your idea?
I've been instructed to protect you, to make sure the right things are said.
You mean you're protecting yourself?
Francis, keep your voice down.
You're not planning some kind of a putsch, are you, Johnny?
All I'm trying to do is to keep your name out of it. You cannot appear before that commission. Just admitting you were there would be the end of you. The end of all of us. O Magnum Mysterium, Thomas Louise to Victoria, 1572.
I wonder if that manuscript... I don't like him calling me Frankie. That's his bloody waistcoat.
You look great.
Look like a clown.
It's what Christine wants, we agreed.
Hey, Dad. Are you ready? I want to show you something.
Hi, Sir Francis.
Fine with it. Are you okay? What do you think, Frankie?
Community's minister shows he hasn't forgotten his roots at daughter's wedding.
I don't see the joke.
No, neither do I.
Come on, Dad. We're just pinning your leg.
I don't see the fucking joke.
Francis! Christine, take the boys for a drink. And get rid of that thing.
Francis.
wrong with me, Catherine?
Only you know the answer to that.
Better apologize.
Henry Stanfield, the recently appointed Truth Commissioner for Northern Ireland, has called for stronger security measures at the Commission's hearings. It followed an incident today when the widow of murdered Edward Lorimer violently attacked one of those who admitted to her husband's murder. Mrs. Lorimer launched herself on him after listening to his apology. Mr. Stanfield said the incident was regrettable, but perhaps understandable, given the years of suffering endured by many of the victims' families who are appearing at the Commission.
May I speak with Christelle?
She's gone away.
I see. For how long?
Who's calling?
Thomas Tallis.
She won't be back anytime soon. Message?
No, thank you. I asked you not to meddle in this process, and you completely ignored me. And I know you're using Laura.
Come on, Henry. She was hardly going to sleep with you.
What is it you're advising the PM on?
Stability of the institutions, keeping her eye on the long-term objective, peace.
Usefully vague. And is she heeding your advice?
So, how do you think the Commission is going?
From yesterday's incident, not bad.
Unfortunate, that.
Yes.
The case of Connor Roach is soon to come for you. The Roaches have asked you to expand the witness list.
Probably within the terms of my remit.
No one's disputing that.
Good. Did you tell Laura that calling Gilroy might be more truth than the PM had in mind?
God, Henry. Can't account for every casual remark.
I'll take that as a yes.
Where's your daughter's baby due, by the way? I understand she and Maria Roach know one another.
What's so special about Francis Gilroy?
He is not responsible for Conor Roach's disappearance.
Yes, so Sinn Féin said. Do you take their word on that?
We all want the Roaches to have closure. A stupid word, that, don't you think? So, the man who actually pulled the trigger would attend the Commission. But it would be best if that were the end of it.
What is it you don't want the world to know, Jake?
Anything that might destabilize the extremely hard-won peace.
The Roaches deserve the truth.
The truth is, Gilroy may have been an idiot once, but compared to most of them, he's Mahatma Gandhi. The truth is, he's one of the reasons most of us have endured a bomb-free existence for 10 years. The truth is, none of us much fancies the alternative.
Is that your advice?
You have a friend named Christelle. Someone paid her to send you up, but because my interest is stability in the institutions, I intervened.
Intervened?
She works here illegally. She has a 6-year-old son. She wasn't difficult to persuade.
Where is she?
That? You don't need to know. If she contacts you again or refers to these again, she'll be deported.
Did you do this, Jake?
These Gilroy's handlers, they're keen to make a point.
Well, it'll take more than a few embarrassing photographs to stop this Commission.
Exactly what I told them, which is why we're not sitting here watching the live version of these on YouTube.
Believe it or not, Henry, I am trying to save lives, not just protect reputations. But do try to be a little more careful with what passes for your sex life. For the commission's sake, if not your own.
My name's Fenton.
Yes, I know who you are. What do you want?
Strike me from the list.
That's not possible.
I don't want to have to lie.
So tell the truth.
They're not going to let me tell the truth. They'll destroy me first. Please, Mr. Stanfield.
We all have to make our own choices, Mr. Fenton.
This is not my choice.
I heard shots.
I ran from the house.
James was lying there in the cold. Blood was pouring from his very head.
Two members of the UDA were convicted of his murder, but released after the Good Friday Agreement. My family and I would like to hear what they have to say.
Thank you, Mrs. Benson. You told me Crystal was out of the equation, and now she shows up at the tribunal. So what is this? Am I fighting on two fronts here? Because if you think this is the way to spare Gilroy's blushes, trust me, I'll make it a lot worse for him, and for all of you, than a few photos of me making a bloody fool of myself. Call me.
Mr. Stanfield?
Yes, what is it?
I was in at the tribunal. If you don't mind saying, you seem to be in a bit of a state. I'm not sure what was going on in there, but I don't want my brothers hearing to be like that. How do you know Anna Conley, the Sinn Féin lawyer? She came into the chamber just now with some other woman.
I've met a lot of lawyers since I came here.
Do you like the truth, Commissioner?
Truth is rarely pure and...
And never simple, yeah, I know. But it's what gets me out of bed in the morning.
Yes, I can see.
I'll make sure Anna Conley not humiliate my family, even if you won't.
I'll see to it that she won't. It's Henry Stanfield. I'd like to speak to Francis Gilbert.
Sorry to hear about your mother.
You'll be able to get me back.
You do what we tell you. You'll be back in Boston before you know it.
Son on my back. I was a filthy punk when I was a boy.
You know this woman?
No.
She turned up with a commission yesterday with your Ms. Conleth.
And?
No, I didn't think you knew.
This is not my joke. I'm sorry.
Who's Madden?
He's nobody. He was a boy.
So why him?
He was there.
And did he kill Connor?
The Roaches want a name. Guilty man. That's what you promised him, isn't it?
They seem to want you.
Those photographs are for Jake Merson's benefit.
What does that mean?
I think it seemed like they're serious about protecting me. A man Dublin and London could deal with.
And?
Some of my colleagues are protecting themselves.
If that's true, why don't you stop them?
I won't name names.
I think you'll let Madden take the rap because it's the least worst option for you.
I didn't kill Connor Roach, but you dragged me before the commissioner would be as if I did. No one will benefit, except those who replace me.
How many times and how many countries have I heard that speech?
You must do what you have to do, Mr. Stanfield. I always knew my job was a poison chalice. What about yours?
Interesting.
Frankie's old school. I'm pleased about the photographs.
Send Mr. Stanfield the other images.
Sorry to wake you.
No, I was.
What's wrong? Well, I just wanted to hear the sound of your voice. Make sure you're all right.
I'm uncomfortable.
Right. Emma.
What is it, Kat?
It's nothing. Good night.
Tender my resignation. I have a daughter who's moved here. She's pregnant, vulnerable. I cannot guarantee her safety. I realize your personal investment in this.
Yes, you made it very plain. This is to be your legacy.
Just let me try to explain.
No, of course not. No, I haven't. Not yet. Yes. All right. All right.
Yes, what is it?
Henry, are you all right?
What is it, Laura?
I'm sorry to pressure you, but you need to make a decision on Gilroy.
You need to know now.
Oh, yes. The Roach case has been moved forward to Thursday.
Take Gilroy off the list. Let's see what this star witness has to say.
You sure?
Yes.
Okay.
Sleep well.
It's the right choice.
Is everything all right? Emma?
She's fine. There's a guard at the house. I know the men on duty. Very discreet. She's in good hands. I was told to give this to you. There was never a commission for you.
Can I offer you a drink?
Thank you, but I'd better get back. Good night, sir.
When we get there, stay close to me. Keep your head up and look straight ahead. Keep everything for the commission. And remember, we're here for you, shoulder to shoulder.
Maria Roach wants me to call the man responsible for Connor's death before the tribunal.
Yes.
Can't give the wretches what they want.
Why not?
Threats have been made.
Threats?
What kind of threats? They've made it plain that they could hurt you if I call Francis Gilroy. Gilroy? The minister?
You have to call him.
Emma, I'm not risking you or my grandchild for a truth commission, not even this truth commission.
See this as an opportunity, Dad. A chance to do something that matters. For those you say matter to you.
I won't make pointless grand gestures.
Right, so when the truth doesn't suit you, it's a pointless grand gesture. You owe this to me. You owe it to my mum. And if you ever, ever hope to see him, you owe it to your grandchild. Do not pass up on this chance. Won't be another. Mike and I have been working on the events that led to the unfortunate death of Connor Roach.
Connor was passing information about Republicans to the police. He'd been seen with a special branch, so he was to be taken over the border and questioned about it. I drove the car for two other volunteers, now dead. He was crying, but no one heard him. He freely admitted what he'd been doing. It was decided to set up a press conference where he'd describe how he was recruited by the police and pass information. But early next morning, he somehow managed to climb out a window. I was supposed to be watching him. I had a gun. I panicked. I chased after him into the woods. I shouted after him that he'd get me in big trouble, not to be stupid. All of a sudden, he's on top of me, punching and kicking me. I was on the ground, trying to push him off. He gets hold of the gun. He's trying to wrestle it off me. And then, I don't know how, the gun went off. He stopped moving. It was a terrible accident. I'm sorry for what happened to Connor. I'm truly sorry.
Very good, Michael.
Can you let me have a copy of that, please, Anna?
I had no idea they'd put so much pressure on you not to call Gilroy. I'm sorry if I...
I sent him instead.
Sure, he was only a child himself.
I'd ask everyone to stand in silent memory of all those who lost their lives in the conflict. Thank you. I'll begin by asking Maria Roach if she would tell us about the events leading up to her brother Connor's disappearance.
When Connor disappeared, he was 15 years old. It was a Thursday night. He said he was going down to the boxing club. He didn't come home.
When another day passed, we went to the police. They told us they believed he'd been abducted by the IRA. A few days later, word reached us. A neighbor said that Connor had been supplying information to the police and that he'd confessed it all, that it was all on tape. How could Connor work for the police? What did he know about anything? Years went by and nobody was able or willing to tell us anything. It was as if he never existed. But we have a right to know, to have his body back where he belongs.
Thank you, Miss Roach.
Commission calls James Fenton.
Please state your name and your connection with the case.
James Fenton, Detective Inspector. Special Branch RUC. Retired.
When did you first encounter Connor Roach?
I can't remember the exact date, but towards the end of January 1992. Connor was suspected of involvement in petty crime, making a nuisance of himself. So we picked him up. He denied any wrongdoing. We had no evidence, so we gave him a word of warning and sent him on his way.
And when did you hear he was missing?
May the 13th. His mother came to the station. No trace of Connor was found. Sometime later, we learned that he had been abducted by the IRA.
And do you know the identity of those who abducted Connor?
No.
Is there anything further you might be able to add, Mr. Fenton? I'd like you to think carefully before you answer.
I'm afraid not. No.
A moment, Mr. Fenton. I think Ms. Roach has some questions.
I want to play a recording relevant to the case. We had no prior knowledge of this.
Ms. Roach, is this recording of legitimate concern to this hearing?
It is. It was given to me by someone involved in Connor's abduction.
Proceed.
My mother has identified this as Connor's voice.
Name.
Connor Roach.
If you ever want to see your mother again, you're going to tell me who, when, where, how often, and why. Am I clear? Why did you do it?
They said they'd get me shot if I didn't type for them.
How often did you meet them?
Twice a week.
What were their names?
Inspector Fenton. T.S. Briggs.
Where did you meet them?
They picked me up in Belfast on the drive.
And?
If I didn't give them information, they said they'd drop me where people would be waiting to give me a head job.
Did they pay you?
I didn't do it for money.
What did you do it for?
I was so scared. I kept saying what would happen if I didn't help them. I didn't do it for money. I'm telling the truth. Can I go home now? Can I go home now?
Mr. Fenton, isn't it true that Connor was working for you?
I didn't say any of those things to Connor.
Is it true that Connor was working for the police?
We needed information to protect lives.
So you used Connor to gather that information?
We met him from time to time, in the same way we met many people.
How many times did you meet him?
Perhaps half a dozen. Can't remember exactly.
And you paid him?
Small amounts. Not very much.
So what are we talking about, £5 or £10? More?
It was mostly about £10. He just wanted to talk, as much as anything. We were like... friends.
Connor said he was forced to supply information.
No one threatened him or said that he was going to be shot.
So why do you think he said those things?
He was frightened. He was to tell them what they wanted to hear.
Mr. Fenton, you were aware of Connor's age?
Look, I don't think you understand what we were having to deal with.
I understand that you were dealing with a child.
Ms. Roach, please let Mr. Fenton finish what he was saying.
If you weren't there, if you hadn't lived through it, you can't understand what it was like. Things were falling apart. When you reported for duty, you never knew what you might be having to deal with. Police officers were handed caseloads of 200, 250 murders, working on them for a couple of months before they themselves were murdered. We were in a war. Things happened that shouldn't happen. I want to say that I regret deeply what happened. I'm very sorry.
Thank you for that. But you were aware of the fate of so-called informers, weren't you?
Yes.
Did he supply you with any information you considered useful?
No.
So a boy lost his life supplying meaningless information in exchange for petty cash? No further questions.
I didn't kill Connor. I'm not the person who killed him.
Thank you, Mr. Fenton. There will be a 5-minute recess.
Do you know about the recording?
Yes, I did.
Why didn't you say?
Honestly, because I couldn't be sure who you might tell.
Would you please state your name and your connection to the case?
My name is Michael Madden.
Mr. Madden?
My name is Michael Madden. Joined the IRA when I was 17. Made me feel big. But I wasn't big. I was an idiot. A message boy. In May 1992, I drove Connor and two volunteers to a farm across the border in County Monaghan.
Connor was dragged into the house and tied to a chair. One of the men began to beat him. Badly.
I don't know.
Phone calls were made to Belfast, and it was decided that we'd make a tape of him admitting what he'd done. He was told after he'd made the tape, he'd make a press statement, and then it would all be over. A couple of hours later, another man arrived from Belfast. And when he saw the state that Connor was in, there was a real bust-up with the interrogator, who was shouting we were all soft in Belfast and too interested in looking good to get our hands dirty. Connor was to be kept for a couple of days until he mended up and could go back for the press conference. But sometime around dawn, he escaped. The commander was screaming at us to find him. I was supposed to be keeping watch, so I panicked. I ran into the woods. But Connor jumped me. He was wild, kicking and punching. He was strong, he got on top of me, pinning me down. But then there was a shot. Connor stopped struggling. He collapsed on top of me. There was arguing about what had happened. It wasn't meant to happen. The two senior men were standing there. One had a gun.
Michael, tell us now who killed Connor.
Get Alan to take you.
Stop. We're not in the house, Dad. We're at the hospital. The baby came early.
What?
I've had the baby.
Where are you?
The Ulster Hospital.
That's good. That's very good. Don't move from there.
Relax, Dad. I'm not moving.
Okay. Okay. I'll be right with you.
You didn't shoot him? But you did order his abduction? And you know who did shoot him? Did you want to say who? Well, whoever pulled the trigger, Roach had it coming. It was a war. Pull yourself together. Move on. Christine wants me to look at seating plans. Someone here to talk to you.
Francis, you know I'm here.
You're here because you think this is your moment.
I'm here to rescue a politically embarrassing situation.
And because you think I won't tell Stanfield it was you shot Roach?
That'll hardly save you.
Might save the party.
It's too late now.
Oh. So what's it to be? Back to all-out war?
Let's just say we'll put a little more backbone into the struggle.
Backbone? Like shooting 15-year-old boys?
He was an informer. Whereas you're not, Francis. Not in your DNA.
It'll stop you with me.
but I want Madden left out of it.
Always a hero, Francis.
Madden wasn't to know.
Useless prick, couldn't even get a simple confession right. It was only luck in him to you, not me.
Yeah, look at that. I can make this difficult for you. Let him go.
You go quietly. I'll see to it Martin goes unharmed. Your statement's been written.
Yes?
Have you got him?
We got him.
Well done. Now let him go.
Can I ask why?
Because I say so. Is that understood? Satisfied? Be ready in an hour. He's beautiful.
Tom.
Your grandfather's name.
How was it today? Don't worry.
I think Maria and her family got what they wanted.
You called Gilroy after all. I knew you'd help. Would you like to hold him?
Sorry. Yeah. Excuse me, I have to take this.
Okay. Congratulations. Beckett told me the good news. Granddad.
You don't think I had anything to do with Madden's performance?
Not I. Others are less sure.
So what now?
Despite today's catastrophe, amazingly, the feeling is it was a minor setback.
Or a minor triumph.
Oh, Henry. You get to call Gilroy. He'll resign. They'll replace him with someone less able and more belligerent, all because the Roaches had to have the truth.
The truth is, Gilroy's guilty.
Gilroy is not guilty. I pleaded with you not to call him.
Why would Madden lie?
Thought he was telling the truth.
What?
Who was it convinced the Roaches that Gilroy shot Connor? Tried to blackmail you. Forced Madden to take the rap. Rafferty isn't protecting Gilroy, he's protecting himself. I've been bossing it from here on in. New Sinn Féin minister.
I've already told the PM I want to resign. I have to get out of this.
Oh, you're not washing your hands of this one, Henry. All sides are agreed. It's entirely my fault for letting Rafferty lead me by the nose. Stanfield is still the best man for the job. PM, pathological optimist, wants you to put all this behind you. I wouldn't disappoint you a second time.
Following the serious revelations concerning a member of the power-sharing executive, both the Taoiseach and I are here tonight to reaffirm our commitment to the Truth Commission. And to offer our thanks to Henry Stanfield, who hasn't shrunk from his task in doing what is necessary, however painful or politically challenging, in offering the truth to a community which has too long waited for answers. For those who have inflicted pain, for those who have endured pain, the truth can and will lead to healing and a lasting peace. Thank you.
Mr. Stanfield, do you have a moment, please?
Open the door, Beckham.
You have something to say to me?
Twice about digging up a past that you don't understand and that doesn't concern you.
Like Gilroy.
Unfortunately, Francis had to be got rid of, so we got you to do it for us. Nothing personal, you understand.
I don't give up.
In light of recent accusations made before the Truth Commission, it's with a heavy heart that I have decided to stand down from my position as minister in a government which I fought long and hard to bring into being. This has been an extremely difficult decision. And though I completely reject the accusations made, the credibility of our party is and always has been paramount. And so I stand aside, confident that those who replace me will not waver in the struggle for a united Ireland, without which this country can never fully be at peace. For me, my gift.
Recent weeks have shown that there are those with the courage and common humanity to face the consequence of their actions. The bombing of the commission has shown that there are those who feel threatened by that courage and will do all in their power to suppress the truth. But the Commission will continue its pursuit of the truth, however inconvenient, not because we want to dwell in the past, but so that our children and grandchildren will be free of the past. Thank you.